Hey everybody, Matt Covert here again from howtobecomearacecardriver.com, and in this video we're going to talk about one of my favorite concepts, and that is slip angle. So let's go ahead and hop right into that. Slip angle is important to understand because I think that is somewhere between three and five, the third and fifth most important concepts in the racing world. And that is because it has everything to do with maximizing your tire's ability to grip, all right? And if you're racing in a stock class or a street category, this is extremely important because there aren't a lot of modifications that are allowed to your vehicle. So you have to take advantage of every single bit of traction that your tires can get you, okay? And that's why this is important. This is all something the driver can control. And if the driver has control over this and can maximize grip, then he's going to have an advantage over everyone else. And that's obviously what we want. So let's talk about what slip angle is. Slip angle is the difference between where a tire is pointed and where it's actually going. And I'll explain that in a second. But it's important to understand that the difference is the angle, okay? So let's look at an example. So let's say we have a tire going down a straightaway, and it's not turning at all, okay? It is going in one single direction, so it is going exactly the same way it is pointed. That tire has a 0 degree slip angle, and we're not worried about that tire. Slip angle occurs when you go into a corner. So let's draw one that's kind of offset here. Oops. There we go. And let's say it's connected to the chassis like that. Right? Let's say that the vehicle is trying to go into a corner this way, all right? And the tire is pointed in this direction here. Oops, let me draw that a little bit better. Tire is pointed in this direction. But since the car has inertia and momentum or what have you, and it's trying to change direction, its tendency is to keep going straight. It doesn't want to turn, okay? And the result of that is a small difference between where the tire is pointed. Let's say this tire is pointed in this direction, but it's actually slipping across the driving surface this way, all right? So rather than, let's draw the same tire down here, rather than kind of going in this arc where the tire is pointed, it's actually going to go here. Okay, so it's actually sliding across the driving surface, if that makes any sense. The difference between where this tire is pointed and where it's actually going to slip across the surface is, we'll go back to this here, it's the slip angle. And this is very important to understand because tires are most efficient when they are slipping across the surface at some degree. Okay? There is a degree that you can go past, so they are less efficient, but it's important to understand that tires are most efficient when they are slipping and have some angle like this. So let's take a look at an example of how much slip angle you could possibly want, all right? So let's say that a tire's optimal slip angle at a certain speed is 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 degrees. That's a little high, but we're going to go with it as an example, okay? So let's say, oh no, we'll get here too. 4, 6, 8. Okay, so let's say that a tire's slip angle curve looks something like this, okay? Up to a point, this tire has the most amount of grip, you can see here, the most amount of grip at this slip angle. We'll just say 2, 4, 6, 8, well, it ends up being more like 10-ish, all right? So let's just say that this is the 10-degree slip angle is the optimal angle at which this tire makes grip. Okay, now if you go past that, obviously you're going to start losing grip again. And if you don't get up to it, then, well, you're leaving traction on the table because you've only gotten up to here or something like that. And this is very important to understand because this is all something a driver can control. If a driver's not driving a vehicle hard enough, he's going to end up somewhere in this range maybe, okay? And look at all that traction he left on the table. Well, a better driver than him is going to get up here and he's just going to be faster. And that's what we want to avoid. You want to be able to get into the sweet spot, which is right about here, right? If you go past that, if you're driving the car too hard, then obviously you're going to be outside of the tire's maximum ability to grip. And incidentally, when you're up here, you're just creating huge amounts of heat because your slip angle is pretty radical. And anytime you have a radical slip angle, just say it's pretty crazy. He's going all the way this way. Big angle. Then you're just generating a ton of heat from traction, and that's no good. Okay, so this is something that you really need to understand. I know I've said that a bunch of times now, but this is a very, very important concept.